My name is Tony Pierce. I am the editor of LAist. I'm also the creator of the Bus Blog at busblog.com.
A couple female vampires from the 4400. I don't know if you watched that.
You know, I watched one of those. I like the one I watched of that.
Yeah, I got to watch it now because these girls were hot.
Uh-huh.
One was evil and one was good. And I want them to bite me and give me immortality, but...
You ain't nothing but a waitress in the sky.
Zona Boy broke my ring my bell cherry.
Said, you know, hey, I'm leaving. I don't know if you've got a new replacement for me, but this Tony Pierce guy, I've met him a couple times. He's cool. And look what he's done for his last company. So she emailed that to her boss, and he wrote me back, he wrote me that very next day. I had only really written like two or three a day on my personal blog. Now you got to double that every single day.
Right.
It's kind of like, yeah, you have to kiss six girls today, Tony. He's giving a little shout out. What's his name?
Simon.
Simon? Woof woof, Simon. I recommend if they're a girl to get naked,
okay,
or topless, or wear really, really scantily, you know, whatever. Just sex sells.
Do you ever find yourself censoring yourself about what you write about in your personal life? Or, as far as you're concerned, is anything goes, and you would write about... Do you understand what I'm saying?
About the disgusting poop I had this morning because of the Jack in the Box tacos from last night?
Exactly.
Yes, I do censor myself. We basically split a bottle of Jim Beam.
Right.
And by halftime, we're making out on the couch. Great. Everything is great, right? Well, she turns a little violent with the booze, apparently. She has a problem with her booze. And she starts throwing things and hitting things. Now, granted, she's topless at the time. She had a distinguishing mark on her boobies, let's say.
I don't even remember what it looks like. He's got a big giant wart on his nose. He votes Republican. George, that was a stupid tie you wore the other day. I don't ever want to see you wearing that tie again.
So that's it's probably one of the hardest city blogs to ever manage, right?
No, it's a piece of cake.
Really?
Yeah.
What do you guess if you wake up at 10:30?
Well, I was up till 7.
Oh.
Yeah.
What were you doing?
I was working. I want, D-list celebrities.
Those are my interests.
Yeah. Yeah. And famous people, you know, Misha Barton, Kristen Dunst, they get lots of FaceTime anyways. Are you having a hard time finding dates?
No, I'm fine. I'm happy right now.
Okay.
Rainforming.
So I was going to say, come on down here. Take you to the pantry. There used to be an awesome Denny's there that every rock star would go to, in the wee hours.
Yeah.
And they tore it down to put in this, fancy, upscale, Italian place. Treehugger.com or treehugger.us.
I was offered to wake and bake before I came here today. I wrote a piece today called There Goes the Holocaust about Mel Gibson losing his contract with ABC to make a Holocaust miniseries. Is calling a lady sugar tits sexist?
People are very, very friendly to me, and when I'm at a bar and they offer me something to drink, I will drink it. And because this is Southern California, they offer me other things, and so a lot of times I will accept that too, just out of being polite, not because I like it. And to be real, real, it doesn't even work on me.
What?
I smoked so much weed in college that it doesn't even work on me anymore. Rolled the joint and threw some hash in there.
And you didn't get high.
I got dizzy and then I had to barf. Green plants are here for your food. And so it's like...
a carnivore and a smoker.
Yeah, so it's like, could there be a bigger hint that pot is okay biblically? Well, wow, how exciting.
Wow, it was very nice talking to you.
Very nice talking to you.
Have a good afternoon.
Much love to Brooklyn.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.
We're sorry. All circuits are busy now. Will you please try your call again later?